Hi, my name is Bhavna. I'm the founder of Cureveda, an award-winning range of plant-based supplements. At Cureveda, we try to keep it as natural as possible by making use of ingredients which are sourced naturally from herbs, spices, food ingredients, and we try to avoid synthetic ingredients altogether. I know during the time of the lockdown, a lot of people have this question about which supplements can be consumed and ways to build immunity. So the recommendations which will be there from my end are to incorporate ashwagandha in your diet. It's a great immunomodulator herb. It helps to build energy as well as immunity, and it also helps to control stress because of its adaptogenic properties. If you're trying to work from home, since the lockdown in most cities has been extended by another 15 days, try and get a Brahmi supplement. It's a great nootropic. It helps to boost your concentration and attention span, also helps to improve memory. If you're looking for something for good sleep, then you can have a valerian root or a melatonin supplement. Now, most importantly, immunity. The one supplement that I recommend everybody to get their hands on is to get some Chyawanprash. Just load up on it. It's so good for building immunity. It is packed with vitamin C. Amla or Indian gooseberry is one of the best ingredients that we have in the Indian system of medicine. Just look for a product which is very nutritious and low in sugar and has a higher concentration of amla in it. Chyawanprash is something which is enjoyed by people of all age groups. It's extremely palatable. Children can have it. And one of the myths about Chyawanprash is that it can be had only during the winter season. Please don't worry about that. It can be had all year round, so you don't need to be having any qualms or any worries about that. Other things which you can get easily from your kitchen pantry, which I would recommend to incorporate in your diet, is begin the day with a shot of turmeric, ginger, lemon, because ginger is again very great for its immunity building properties. Turmeric has anti-inflammatory properties. Add some pepper to it, which will help to improve the absorption of the nutrients from these herbs. Try and have a glass of warm water in the morning as well as in the evening. You can also have tulsi ka kadha. Just boil some tulsi leaves, and if you want to make it more palatable, you can add lemon to it, or you can add jaggery or coconut palm sugar. You can also add honey to it. Both honey and tulsi are very good for warding off respiratory infections. They're very good for bronchial health, so definitely recommend it during this time. You know, I think it's most important that you try and tweak the dishes that you make every day by substituting the unhealthy ingredients with certain ingredients which have better therapeutic properties or are healthier for you and will be more beneficial for you in the long term. So I'm going to just help and demonstrate that for you by showing you my version of these healthy oat pancakes. And the idea is that I can just show you how I've substituted some unhealthy ingredients for healthy ingredients, and you can do that hopefully for other dishes as well. So I am no master chef. I'm not even very fond of cooking, but I'm fond of eating healthy. And because of the lockdown, I've been trying to look for healthier versions of dishes that I enjoy. So these are the pancakes that I've just made. I don't know if you can see them, but I have made them with oats instead of maida. So oats has this ingredient called polysaccharide, which helps to boost moisture on the epidermis, and it helps to get rid of dry, dehydrated skin. Also, I've cooked the pancakes in coconut oil. This is cold pressed coconut oil, which helps to maintain immunity. It helps to maintain a healthy digestive tract, and it also has very good anti-aging properties. After that, I just drizzled it with honey. Like I said, honey is great for infections and it's good for skin. Topped it with bananas, chopped bananas for phosphorus as well as good digestion. I've added pomegranate to it, which helps to keep a healthy scalp and is very useful for hair health, along with providing iron. I've also added a dash of cinnamon to it. It has antibacterial, antifungal and antiviral properties. You can add other herbs which you like. You can add licorice, you can add nutmeg, whatever you find more palatable. Now what I am going to do is I'm actually going to add some chopped chocolate to it. Chocolate is a great antioxidant. I actually have a whole slab of chocolate here with me, and I have a little bit through the day. There's nothing wrong with having a bit of chocolate. I'm actually fortunate enough also to have some amla chutney. So if you have amla murabba, amla chutney lying at home, that's a great option. I'm also going to add some coconut to it, because that again is just good for skin and it's just good for all round health. And then the icing on the cake for me, or really the topping on the pancake for me, is adding these seeds. I love to have seeds to the day. So these are pumpkin seeds, watermelon seeds, and I think flax seeds. Yeah, so sunflower seeds are great in vitamin E. They help to keep good, healthy, glowing skin. Watermelon seeds are very good to provide you with a bunch of protein which you need through the day. So it's all in all quite a nutritious dish, and I think it looks quite tasty as well. So just make something like this, opt for healthier version, begin your breakfast, begin your day with a healthy pancake, and try and make the same kind of healthy choices through the day. Keep healthy and keep safe.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.